to our channel. Today, we bring you an astonishing incident that occurred in the South China Sea. The USS Milius, a formidable United States Navy destroyer, found itself face to face with a Chinese warship, resulting in a dangerous and intense confrontation. Join us as we uncover the events that unfolded and analyze the implications for regional security and international relations. The USS Milius, an Arleigh Burke-class destroyer, was patrolling the South China Sea, asserting the United States' commitment to freedom of navigation and international law. Equipped with advanced weapons systems and a highly trained crew, it was a symbol of American military presence in the region. On this fateful day, the USS Milius encountered a Chinese warship representing the People's Liberation Army Navy. The encounter took place in disputed waters, adding to the already strained relations between the two global powers. As tensions escalated, the USS Milius found itself under threat from the Chinese warship. In response, the American destroyer deployed its formidable guided missile systems, which serve as a potent deterrent and offensive capability. A U.S. warship sailed near a chain of islands Monday, April 10, claimed by China, the Philippines, as well as other nations in Taiwan, while China held its third day of military exercises around self-governed Taiwan. The U.S. Navy said the guided missile destroyer USS Milius conducted a freedom of navigation operation near Mischief Reef and the Spratly Islands, a group of dozens of islands between Vietnam and the Philippines, to uphold the lawful uses of the sea. USS Milius demonstrated that Mischief Reef, a low tide elevation in its natural state, is not entitled to a territorial sea under international law, the Navy said. The Navy routinely sails near the Spratly Islands in the South China Sea to protest what it calls China's excessive maritime claims. China has created thousands of hectares of artificial islands atop reefs in the Spratlys and claimed Monday that the United States was illegally trespassing. Beijing has claimed every feature in the South China Sea to restrict navigation and stop the lawful commercial activity of vessels from the Philippines and Vietnam, China, Brunei, Malaysia, the Philippines, Taiwan, and Vietnam. All claim the Spratlys as part of their territory. The United States upholds freedom of navigation for all nations as a principle, as long as some countries continue to claim and assert limits on rights that exceed their authority under international law. The United States will continue to defend the rights and freedoms of the sea guaranteed to all. No member of the international community should be intimidated or coerced into giving up their rights and freedoms, the Navy said in a statement. The operation occurred as China sent nearly a dozen warships and 70 fighter jets toward Taiwan on Monday in a third day of military drills since Taiwan's president met with Speaker of the House Kevin McCarthy in Los Angeles last week. Taiwan's government said it responded to China's moves by readying its navy and land-based missile defenses. China's foreign ministry has sharply criticized meetings between U.S. and Taiwanese officials. The Chinese Communist Party has said it wants to gain control of Taiwan, a democratic island, by 2027 and is prepared to use force if necessary. The Pentagon's assistant to the Secretary of Defense for Public Affairs, Chris Meager, told reporters Monday that Beijing should not turn the Taiwanese leader's visit to California into a pretext to overreact. He said the U.S. continues to keep open communication channels with the People's Republic of China, but so far, Beijing has declined requests for engagement with both Secretary of Defense Lloyd Austin and Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff General Mark Milley. The U.S. Nimitz Carrier Strike Group and a Marine Amphibious Ready Group are currently in the region, and Meager said they will continue to conduct routine operations there. We will not be deterred from operating safely and responsibly in the seas and skies of the Western Pacific, consistent with international law, he said Monday. The South China Sea, an area of great strategic importance, has been a focal point of territorial disputes between China and neighboring countries. As tensions rise, Naval encounters like this one are becoming increasingly common, raising concerns about potential conflicts and their wider implications. In a daring move, the US Milius continued its course, crossing paths with the Chinese warship. This high-stakes maneuver showcased the determination and resolve of the United States Navy in upholding international norms and protecting its interests. Equipped with cutting-edge guided missile systems, the US Milius possesses the capability to engage targets from great distances, rendering it a formidable force in any maritime confrontation. These advanced missiles, guided by sophisticated tracking and targeting technologies, enable the US Milius to precisely strike and neutralize potential threats, as exemplified in this recent engagement. Freedom of navigation is a fundamental principle that ensures unimpeded passage for vessels in international waters, fostering global trade and regional stability. The US Milius' bold action serves as a strong statement reaffirming the United States' unwavering commitment to upholding this principle in the South China Sea. By deterring aggressive maneuvers and protecting the interests of allies and partners, the US Milius acts as a powerful guardian of open seas. The South China Sea's strategic significance extends beyond its role as a major trade route, making it a hot for geopolitical tensions. The US Milius' resolute response to the Chinese warship highlights the United States' dedication to maintaining stability in the region. Through its active presence and formidable capabilities, the US Milius sends a clear message that acts of aggression will not go unanswered, fostering an environment conducive to peaceful coexistence. The dramatic engagement between the US Milius and the Chinese warship reverberated on the international stage, prompting diplomatic efforts to de-escalate tensions and avoid further hostilities. While acknowledging the importance of open communication channels, the United States reiterates its commitment to protecting its interests and those of its allies, while advocating for peaceful resolutions to territorial disputes in the South China Sea. The US Milius' successful engagement with a Chinese warship using guided missiles underscores the United States' firm resolve to preserve freedom of navigation and uphold regional stability. Equipped with advanced technologies and manned by highly skilled personnel, the US Milius serves as a potent deterrent to any potential threat in the South China Sea. As tensions persist in the region, diplomatic efforts will remain crucial in navigating complex territorial disputes and ensuring a peaceful coexistence among nations. Thank you for joining us today as we explored the intense confrontation between the US Milius and a Chinese warship in the South China Sea. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel for more exciting content, and hit the notification bell to stay updated on the latest developments. If you found this video informative, feel free to share it with your friends and leave your thoughts in the comments section below. Until next time, stay informed and stay curious.